Yuri van Leeuwen, working at the Faculty of Astronomy in Amsterdam, does research into pulsars. Pulsars are the remains of a star after it explodes at the end of its life. They are as heavy as normal stars, but because of the explosion, they are so compressed that they are 100,000 times smaller. Imagine the weight of Mount Everest contained in a teacup. Because of their compression, pulsars are ideally suited to investigate the properties of gravity and material in our universe.
Zo, sterrenkundigen zitten altijd op de bovenste verdieping en zo ook hier. Dit is onze oefentelescoop, hier werken onze studenten mee. Dit is een optische telescoop. De telescoop die we voor dit project gebruiken is een radiotelescoop. Dus die is veel groter dan deze, 100 keer zo hoog, 100 keer zo groot in diameter ook. En wat we met dit project doen is dat we de data van die telescoop, die komt naar Nederland. Daar zijn we heel trots op dat we in Nederland het grote rekencentrum daarvoor zijn. Dan bij SARA, het supercomputingcentrum, wordt die data gereduceerd. Hij wordt opgeslagen in Groningen en dan komt uiteindelijk het resultaat hier, waar de onderzoekers zijn in Amsterdam. En het is dus via die surfnet lichtpaden dat we die vier locaties aan elkaar kunnen plakken tot één supercomputing netwerk.
De rol van SARA is het ondersteunen van Yuri in het gebruik maken van de supercomputer.
Nou, dit is nu een van de kasten van de supercomputer Huygens. In deze kast zitten 12 nodes. Iedere node is in feite één grote, hele zware computer. En in één zo'n computer zitten 32 cores. In totaal hebben we 9 van deze kasten. Keer 12 van die nodes, keer 32 cores, komen we op 3328 cores. Komt u maar even mee voor de rest. Ja, aan de linkerkant ziet u een aantal van de harde schijven van de supercomputer. Aan de rechterkant ziet u een deel van het netwerk. En hier staan nog kasten met echte computers erin.
Using the dynamic light paths of SurfNet, pulsar researchers are able to set up connections in a simple manner over the SurfNet network. While using these connections, you do not encounter other traffic. It's as if you have a whole motorway just to yourself. Therefore, the quality is very high while remaining constant. In this way, it is possible to quickly set up a flexible, distributed instrumentarium with reliable capabilities. The dynamic light paths offer unimagined new possibilities for remote cooperation and for the efficient use of otherwise costly resources.
I'm working together with Yuri van Leeuwen. Yuri is basically been taking care of arranging these connections between telescopes, data reduction centers, and our institute here. And I've been primarily working on investigating what kind of techniques we can use to analyze the data. There's a huge amount of data that needs to be stored, and it also takes a lot of computing time to find a signal in the data. But in the end, if you've done it properly, you can actually reduce all that data down to just a few very interesting numbers. So this is one of the boxes of disks that we had shipped to us from the telescope. You can see that, well, one of the disks is already broken, unfortunately. But each one of these disks has about a terabyte of data on it, so there's about 6 terabytes of data in total here. And it costs a lot of money to buy all these disks, and it costs a lot of money to ship all of this data around so that we can get it somewhere where we can actually process the data. So it'd be much, much better if we could actually just transfer all the data over a network, and that way we wouldn't have to buy these disks and we wouldn't have to pay all these shipping costs, and we could actually get through a lot more data and discover a lot more nice things. So I'm just going to go plug this into our computer so we can analyze it. So in Holland, we're mostly using the Westerbork telescopes. Those data are generally recorded on site at the Westerbork telescope. And then if we want to reduce the data, then we need to transfer it from the telescope to Astron. We're going to use the Enlighten Your Research Prize that we've won from SurfNet to make